What's up, everybody? It's Jake One, and this is the making of Drake's song that I produced called The Furthest Thing. So basically, when I made this beat, I started off with a sample, you know, like always. And, you know, it was cool because I found a couple pieces in the record, so I could have an intro and the main piece. So yeah, you know, I started this beat on the boss of my operation, the ASR-10. I did something different this time because I used Pro Tools to do the drums. It's something I've kind of been experimenting with because the ASR, though I love what it sounds like sometimes, the sequencer has its limitations. I can't really do things that make it sound like 2013 on there sometimes. It's like, I don't want to just always sound like 1990, whatever. That's why I'm kind of doing the drums on Pro Tools sometimes, because you can put the little Lex Luger stutters and, you know, some of these things. It's really simple to just put it in there. You know, the whole Drake situation came about. It's kind of funny because he followed me on Twitter one day, and I didn't even realize, because, you know, I'm not necessarily checking who's following me every day and keeping updated. But basically, I was wondering, like, why are people asking me crazy stuff about Drake on Twitter all the time? Like, it was strange. Some dude wanted me to, it's like, can you please retweet my painting of Drake? So, you know, he'll see it. And I was like, why would I do that? I don't even know Drake. So, he was like, he follows you. I was like, oh, shit, that's tight, you know? So anyways, I didn't necessarily just bombard him with beats or nothing immediately, because I don't think he was working on his album or whatever. And I was in Hawaii with my family, and Drake was just playing on the radio nonstop. Like, just literally every song was Drake. So we were standing like the Mickey Mouse Resort, and I remember going up to the room, and I was like, man, I'm gonna send him some beats. Like, what am I doing? I'm fucking up. So I hit him on Twitter, told him I wanted to send him beats, and he was like, please do. I sent him, and I swear, like, maybe in 20 minutes, he was like, I want this one and this one, and that's kind of where it started. And, you know, over a course of, like, a year, he picked a bunch of beats, and that was the one that ended up making it, so. The replay, you know, unfortunately, with samples, there is a risk sometimes that the people that own the sample can be difficult, and they either want too much money for you to clear the sample, or they just don't want you to use the period. And this is more of a case, I think, of, you know, financially, it just was, they wanted ridiculous terms, you know, to use the master. So, you know, when I get in that situation, I call G Coop. You know, he's one of the best in the world at, you know, reinterpreting the sound and getting, you know, whatever it is that they did on that record, the certain mics and drums.
So do you have
drums,
the choir in there and all that?
So yeah, G Coop initially did all the music part and sent that to me. So then I chopped that up, put it in the ASR, recorded it back into Pro Tools. And then he also got a little choir together to do the voice part, which was the trickiest part. They ended up supplementing that. 40 ended up putting a bigger choir on it, because he wanted it to sound more like the record, because the record might have had 100 people singing. We don't know, we weren't there. You know, it's tricky trying to reconstruct these things and build them from the ground up, but it's dope too. It's like a different kind of challenge. It's kind of weird. It was different for me because I started on the ASR-10. I did the sample and the bass line on there, and I did the drums on Pro Tools. This is a little different for me. So basically what I started was the intro. That's just a little intro, just, you know, kind of give a, set the mood, and then the rest of the beat is off this choir sample. So that's the main loop. Then I played a bass line. This sample in the bass line. I recorded the main loop, well, the loops, the music, and the bass line in the Pro Tools, and then I kind of just started stacking, my drum sounds. I put a little cymbal thing in there, real simple, just kind of to get that texture. I like how it had the live band in the sample. You can tell it's recorded real far away, so I tried to get that same effect, but just a little bit. From there, I think I added toms next. Adding the toms. So here's the. From there, kind of had to go for the kick and snare. These will be available on my drum kit, Snare Jordan 2. And that might be something you might want to buy if you want to make some shit like this. I'm listening to all the young shit that's going on. I'm like, I need some of those machine gun snares and shit in my beat. So. The Lex Luger is kind of, he's the one that kind of made it famous. Kind of started doing that with my sounds. So there's a lot of that in this beat. That's kind of like the drum track in general. And this is, this version is actually way different than the one on the album because they sped it up a bit. And, we also had to get the sample replayed. So there was a whole lot of other shit that happened from this point to the record.